Hello everybody. So in the light part 1 I have discussed few topic of the chapter light. In this part 2 I am going to discuss more topics under that heading light. Okay, so the first thing that I am going to discuss is what here difference. Yes, difference between real and virtual images. So few points I have discussed in my previous video, in detail I am going to discuss now. So real image can be obtained on the screen, but what about the virtual image? Virtual image cannot be obtained on a screen. The rays of light after reflection meet at a point where in real image, and that is why there is a formation of the real image. But what about the virtual image? The rays of light after reflection appears to meet, to diverge from a point. So this is the difference. Here actually they meet, and here what? They appears to meet. Clear? Appears to diverge. It is always inverted, and this one virtual image is always erect. Then real image formed in front of the mirror, whereas virtual image formed what? Behind the mirror. Clear? Now next topic that I am going to discuss is lateral inversion. Lateral inversion is what? Like if you stand in front of a plain mirror, you see your image on it, and the image looks exactly like you, and it is of the same size also, and you know, these are the characteristics of the image formed by a plain mirror that I have discussed in my previous video. Okay, so now I am discussing this topic. So for this, now if you hold a pen in your right hand, what will happen? You will see the image where of that pen in your left hand. Okay, and thus the right of the object becomes left of the image, and the left of the object becomes what? Right of the image. Clear? As it is shown here. Clear? You can see very clearly. So this type of phenomenon is called as what? This is called as lateral inversion. Thus we can say that the interchange of left and right side in the object and image formed by the plane mirror is called as what? Is called as a lateral inversion. So in this figure, it is very clear. You can see here in figure A, here is B and here is A. But inside the mirror you will see A and B. Means what? Right appears left side, and left side appears right side. Same thing happened in B also. You can see here is F. Here lines are here. Clear? And here you see lines what? Left side. So here you see lines right side. Here you see lines left side. So this is called as what? Lateral inversion. Lateral inversion produced by a plane mirror is similar to the inversion that occurs on holding paper used to dry ink while writing. So lateral inversion of letters, of course these letters also you will see, when you will see in the mirror you will find very clear view of lateral inversion. So the lateral inversion of letters like A, H, I, M, O, T, U, you will not find. Clear? You will not find the lateral inversion in these letters. Why? Because there is no difference between the right and the left. So like A, there is no difference between the right and left. Like when you write F, there is difference between the right and left. When you write E, there is difference between the right and left. Like the right side you will find the lines, left side you will not find lines. So you will get the image, you will get the, means when you will see these in the mirror, you will get this laterally inverted. Okay, the best example you must have noticed or not, I don't know, but next time if you have not noticed, then please notice that the front of an ambulance has a letter written in the form of what? Ambulance. So that way it is written. Clear? It is written this way, but actually it is what? Why it is written like this? So that the driver of the vehicle moving ahead of the ambulance reads the word laterally inverted as what? As ambulance in his rear view mirror. as shown in this figure here. So it is written like this. When you will see it, you will find it like this. But when you will see the, when you will see in the mirror, that means when you will see in the water, in the van or in the vehicle that is ahead of this ambulance, in that mirror, if you will see in the rear view mirror, if you will see, you will find this. You get the side mirror there. In the vehicle, side mirror is there. So when that vehicle is ahead of this ambulance, clear, when that vehicle is ahead of this ambulance, then in that mirror, in the mirror of that vehicle, you will find ambulance written like this. And then what they do, people give the way to the ambulance. Okay, now next I'm going to discuss the characteristics of the image formed by a plane mirror. So the first characteristics is that image is what? Upright or erect. It's the best example when you see yourself in the mirror. So you get erect image, and this image is what? Virtual also. You cannot take it on the screen, and the image is of same size as the object also, and it is laterally inverted also. Now this word is very clear to all of you, and the image is far, is as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Okay, now I'm going to discuss the new thing, that is the regular reflection and irregular reflection. Regular reflection means what? The reflection of light from a smooth and polished surface. Smooth and polished surface such as plane mirror is called regular reflection. So if a parallel, you can see in the picture also, it is very clear that if a parallel beam of light is incident on a plane mirror, what happens? After reflection, the beam of light is also parallel. So here you can see, like if this one is A, this one is what? B, and this one is C. Then here also, this one is what? This is the reflected rate. So I am writing here A1, here I am writing B1, and here I am writing C1. Okay, so these are also what? Parallel. Means the incident rays are parallel, as well as the reflected ray will also be parallel. So this type of reflection is called as what? Regular reflection. Now, next is a irregular reflection. Just opposite of it, the objects other than the plane mirror are not perfectly smooth. And when they are not perfectly smooth, then what happens? Then when a beam of light falls on such a surface which is not perfectly smooth and polished, like wall, wood, paper, etc., then the different portions of the surface reflect light in what? Different direction. Such a reflection of light from an uneven surface is called irregular or diffused reflection. Clear? Which type of reflection? Irregular or diffused reflection. So for example, we can say in simple word we can say that in irregular reflection, incident rays are parallel but reflected rays are not parallel, and such type of reflection is called as what? Irregular reflection. So thus we can say that it is the diffuse light obtained after reflection from uneven surfaces of objects which enables us to see them and their surroundings. So this is very, very good. Here you can see, like this one is A1, take it A1, this one is B1, and this one is what? C1. So here you can see these A1, B1, C1, they are what? Parallel. But what about this? Here you can see this one is A2, this one is what? This one is A2, this one is B2. Okay, and this one is what? C2. So are they parallel? They are not parallel. Clear? Now, next, uses of a plane mirror. So some uses of plane mirrors I am going to discuss here. First, it is used as a dressing mirror. Yes, dressing table is there in your house. You must have seen. And that mirror is what? Dressing mirror. Then in the optician's room also it is used. Why? To double the effective length of the room. A mirror is kept what? On the opposite wall of the room. So the mirrors are fixed on the opposite walls. Why? Just to double the effective length of the room, and so room look what? Very big. Then in the barber's shop also you must have seen that there is two mirrors. One is in front of you and one is at the back of you. So For in barber's shop, for seeing the rear view at the back, two mirrors are fixed on the opposite walls facing each other. Then in periscope also, kaleidoscope also, solar cooker, plane mirrors are used. And as a rear view mirror in front of the driver in a vehicle, that also what? This plane mirror is used. Now this speed, next topic is the speed of light. So, speed of light is what? The light, I have discussed also earlier, that light can travel through vacuum, and that is why we get the light from the sun, because that light rays has to pass through the space, and there you find vacuum, means that place is what? Vacuum. So because of this property, sun rays can reach to us. So we can say that the speed of light is what? 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second in what? In 1 second. Clear? So thus the speed of light in vacuum is, or we can say, or air is what? 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. It is the maximum speed of light in a transparent medium. Transparent medium means what? A medium through which light rays can easily pass is called as what? Transparent medium. Light slows down, and the speed of light in water is 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and in a glass it is what? 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. This is all you have to learn. It is very important also. You can learn it. At least three, like air or vacuum, water and glass, you have to learn. So all three is given here, and all three you have to learn. Okay. Now, next is the constituent colors of white light from the sun. If white light from the sun is seen through a glass prism, then you will find that it splits into its constituent colors, and you know you get which type of effect, a rainbow type of pattern you will see there. In that rainbow, what the many colors are arranged this way, many colors are there. Which are the colors here? Violet, blue, then violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red, and they are in a fixed pattern. Clear? And that pattern is called, means we can remember these colors in order by the word Vibgyor. Clear? So it is very easy to learn Vibgyor word, and from this word you can learn all the color also. V means violet, I means indigo, B means blue, G means green, Y means yellow, O means orange, and R means red. Okay, now next. This is very common. It is not very common, but when you will see it, you can find it. And it is very interesting, and it is very good to see also, that in rainy season, the rainbow is seen in the sky sometimes after the rains. Not always, sometimes after the rains, in a direction opposite to the sun. It is due to sunlight falling on the raindrops present in the atmosphere. And the raindrops would behave like a small prism. So white light of the sun is split into its constituent color, and constituent colors means what? Vibgyor. So Y-V-I-B-G-Y-O-R, Vibgyor. Okay, next thing is, actually the white light is made up of what? Colors mixed together with a separate boundary in between them, and out of which 7 colors are prominent, and they are what? Vibgyor. So now I think you have become very familiar with this word, and it is very easy to learn also all 7 colors in a perfect order. Next I am going to discuss is the primary colors. Primary colors are the colors of light by mixing which light we obtained white light, and these are what? Red, green and blue. So which are the primary colors? Red, green and blue. If red, green and blue lights are projected on a white screen at the same point, then which light you will obtain, means which light you will see? You will see white light. It is impossible to obtain either red or green or blue light by mixing the light of what? Any two other colors. But light of all other colors can be obtained by mixing the light of any two of the three colors, red, green and blue. Means what? Means white light you can observe, you can obtain. Red light, it is very difficult. Clear? But by mixing red or green, it is difficult. You will get something else. Okay? So, but light of all other colors can be obtained by mixing the light of any two of the three colors. Which are the three colors? Primary colors like red, green and blue. And that is why red, green and blue, they are called as what? Primary colors. So when red, green and blue are mixed together, you get which color? White color. Clear? Now, next. Secondary colors. If we have discussed about the primary colors, then let's discuss about the secondary color. Secondary colors are the color of light which are obtained. How? By mixing, yes, two primary colors together. So like yellow, then cyan and magenta. The red and green, you can see here the red, this is red color, clear, and this one is what? Green. So when they are mixed together, then there is a formation of what? Yellow color. This you can also do. You take the red pencil color and red and green you mix, you will get what? Yellow color. This is very interesting. Because when you are doing, that time your concept also becomes clear and you think that, I got it this. Because when you study and when you practically you can do that thing, then it becomes very interesting. Now, next is that if green and blue lights are projected on a white screen, then you obtained which color? Cyan color. Cyan color means peacock blue. Very nice color it is. So, green and blue mix together and there is a formation of what? Cyan. Clear? So, this is green, this one is blue and this one is what? Cyan color. Okay? Peacock blue color. Very pretty color, very good, nice color. Then the next is that when blue and red lights are projected on a white screen, then you have obtained what? Magenta. Clear? So, blue color. Red color, and this is the mixing of means when you mix blue and red, you will get magenta color. This is also very pretty color. Now, so we can say that the secondary colors are what? Yellow, cyan and magenta. So secondary colors, primary colors are blue, green, red, and secondary colors yellow, cyan and magenta. A color TV or computer screen has array of what? Tiny spots. Each spot is composed of three phosphor dots corresponding to the primary colors red, green and what? Blue. Okay. The colors seen on the screen are due to the combination of what? These primary colors. And which are the primary colors? Red, green and blue. RGB. Red, green, blue. The effect of mixing of primary colors is shown in figure also. You can see very clear here. Clear. So here Y stands for what? Yellow. Yellow. C stands for cyan. And M stands for magenta. And W stands for white. So W when you get, when all the colors mixed together. Okay. So here is very clear. Clearly it is mentioned here, red and green, yellow, green and blue, cyan, blue and red, magenta, and when all three mix, then you get what? White. The pigment colors are not pure. Okay, these are the things that you should know. Yellow and blue, white, magenta and green, white, cyan and red, white. A washerman uses what? Little blue indigo after washing the white clothes so as to make the yellowish tint of clothes white. Okay. Now, next. Subtraction of colors. What do you mean by the subtraction of colors? A transparent object allows the light of certain color to pass through it and absorbs the light of rest of the colors. Its color is the color of light that passes through it. Very clear? So a transparent object allows the what? Light of certain color to pass through it. And what they do? They absorb the rest of the color. So the color which is passing through it, that is the color. Clear? For example, a red cellophane paper passes only water, red light. And so that is why we see red cellophane paper. A blue cellophane paper passes which light? Blue light. And so we say that this cellophane paper is water, blue. So if anything seems of that color, it means that substance allowing that color only to pass through it. And rest of the colors that substance absorbs. Okay, now color of opaque object. When white light falls on an opaque object, it reflects the light of some colors and absorbs the light of rest of the colors. The color of an opaque object is the what? The color which it reflects and that reaches our eyes. Very good. So two things are there. When we see the color, when that color, that means the light of that color passes through it, through the transparent objects, we find that substance of that color. And the second, when we talk about the opaque object, then in opaque object, the opaque object reflects the color of light. That light, through that light only we can say that the given opaque object is of which color. Okay, next. Many examples I am giving here. Like if the body reflects light of what? All the colors. All the colors. Remember, when all the colors, then body appears what? White. When body reflects light of all the colors, it appears what? White. And if the body reflects none of the colors, then what will happen? It means none of the colors means what? It is absorbing all the colors. So it appears what? Black. Thus, a red object will reflect which light? Red light. A blue object will reflect which light? Blue light. Green object will reflect which light? Green light. Yellow object will reflect which light? Yellow light. Clear? Now, next. Now, I'm going to make this point very clear through this example. Many examples I have taken here. Like a piece of white paper appears white in light. Why? Because it reflects all the colors. Very clear? When it reflects all the colors, the object seems white. When it absorbs all the colors, the object seems black. Okay? Now, a red rose appears red in white light. Why? Because it reflects the light of red colors only and absorbs the light of what? Rest of the colors. And so the red rose appears red. I have discussed earlier also. White rose appears white. Why? Because it reflects all the colors. Red rose appears red because it reflects only red colors. Leaves appear green. Why? Because it reflects only green color. Clear? Because they reflect only green light. And what about the others' light? Others' light absorbed through it. Okay? Now, next. Next is, if a red rose is seen in green light, yes, then what happens? Then it appears black. Why? Because rose absorbs the green light falling on it and reflects what? Nothing. So it appears black. Same way, if a red rose is seen in red light, then what will happen? It will appear bright red. Isn't it? Why? Because the rose reflects the red light falling on it and absorbs nothing. So I think all the topics that I have discussed in this video have become very, very clear to all of you. If you get any problem, see the video again and again to clear out your concept. Okay, so thank you very much for this class and have a nice day.